In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the master unit to control the ADR functions in NUENDO. Now, it's first important that you understand how ADR works in NUENDO, and to do that, please watch the ADR tutorial found on Steinberg's YouTube channel. Then, once you've done that, come back and we'll go through all the functionality on the hardware control surface. As you saw in the ADR tutorial, it's preferred to use the preference Cycle follows range selection. I've mapped that preference to this user definable key here. So I'm going to turn the preference on. And now I can use the range selection mode, find the dialog line that I want to replace, select it. The cycle has followed my range selection. And now I can create a cycle marker here on the control surface just by going set and enter. Now, as you can see, I've created a cycle marker around that dialog line that we'll use later when we're recording the dialog itself. Once you've completed spotting all the dialog for your project, we can now use the hardware control surface to begin the recording process. So if you remember from the previous tutorial, there is an extra tab in the transport section of the NUAGE master controller just for ADR. When we go to that tab, we have some dedicated controls just for the ADR recording process. The main issue here is to switch the transport controls into ADR mode. We do that by hitting the transport switch here. Now, what's happened is the stop, play, and record buttons have changed their function into dedicated ADR recording functions. The way this works is, let's say we're on our first take and we want to rehearse for that take. We can use the play button to perform a rehearse action. Then, once the talent is ready to record the line, we use the record button to record. And then once we get a good take and we want to review, you use the play and stop buttons together to use the review function. Having these functions mapped directly to the transport keys on the hardware surface makes it easy to go through the recording process quickly. The touchscreen displays information about the current take, including the character name, the dialogue, and the take number. On the bottom, the encoders give you direct access to the control room's guide level, M&E level, and the click level. Additionally, we have another 8 user definable keys in the upper left-hand side for custom functions. If you've imported your take list from an external file, you might notice that the marker ID and take number are different. If that's the case and you want to locate to the take number instead of the marker ID, when you first type in a marker number to locate to, you can switch between marker ID and take number. This makes it easy to follow the order of the imported list.